So with the delegation's election results the other day, we learned that Colorado's delegation went from 4 Republicans to 3 Democrats, went from that to 4 Democrats, 3 Republicans. But what people really need to know is that our congressional delegation works incredibly well together to represent Colorado businesses and our constituents. Secondly, what you need to know is that what this does in Congress, you have a Senate who maintains a Republican majority and a House that maintains a House majority with Democrats. Basically, that's a check on power for Congress. What one sends to the other has to agree to. So if it's too crazy one way or the other, not only is it not going to get to the president, it's not going to leave Congress. Why that's good? When our founding fathers decided how they were going to set up our check and balance on power, they envisioned Congress as a teacup. The House, which is elected every 2 years, somewhat represented the teacup itself as passionate. With the whims that happens in politics, it could boil over, but the Senate itself would catch that. The things that really were most important would move more slowly, but they would happen incrementally every 6 years as the Senate is elected. So what we see is a check and balance on power. Looking ahead, what that really means for House leadership, presumptive Speaker Nancy Pelosi has said, you know, her top priorities are healthcare reform, specifically prescription drug prices reduction, and then with that, campaign finance reform. And then her third priority, as kind of an olive branch for bipartisan work, is infrastructure investment.